morning and good afternoon, gentlemen. So right now, founding director of Connecting Asia is here in the main office, secretariat of Connecting Asia here in Malaysia, Johor Bahru. So in a while, I'm inviting him to answer the questions which will come from your side, and he will also inform us about the overall online conference, the procedures of 505 slides, poster presentation and normal presentations. So right now he is here in the office, so you can share this Facebook page live video to the maximum groups and with the maximum people. Another thing, important thing, is that you can ask your questions in the comments box, so we will ask the questions to founding director. So right now founding director is with us, and I'll invite him, and I'll sit aside because of the social distancing, so stay tuned with us. So I will ask, I will invite founding director Connecting Asia, Dr. Muhammad Imran Qureshi. Please, sir.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Hello everyone and good evening. I hope everyone is safe, and we are live here for a question answer session about 4th Asia International Multidisciplinary Conference from Connecting Asia. As we know, recently we are facing unprecedented challenges. Not only us, but all the world is facing these challenges now. So let's see how we can settle, and I hope everybody is taking good care of themselves and their family members and friends. So we need to be at the social distancing, and we need to stay home, and we have to work from home. So this is our routine life since last month. I think everybody is settled, and we are well aware of the danger we are dealing with now. So let us just focus on few critical points, because I saw many people asking questions on Facebook and on my personal WhatsApp messages and on our office. So let's see how we can settle these questions. So let me give you a brief of this online session for 4th Asia International Multidisciplinary Conference. The conference will be held on 17th and 18th of April, as we scheduled earlier before this coronavirus outbreak. So we'll stay on our schedule, but we have extended the date for abstract submission. That would be on 15th of April. Okay. Now the conference would be on 17th of April evening, 6 p.m. Malaysian time to 7 p.m. Malaysian time. We are going to have our opening session, where we have invited Prof. Giri, the the Journal of Cleaner Production Editor-in-Chief. He would be our keynote speaker, and then myself would be second keynote speaker, and then from Nigeria, Dr. Aliyu would be. And then at the same time, this ceremony would be officiated by our Vice Chancellor from UTM, and our MC would be Dr. Abdullah from UTM. So this is our opening session. Remember, the dates are 17th April, 6 p.m. evening Malaysian time, and this would be our opening session. We will send a link to all our participants for this. Remember why we decided to continue our journey, and we decided to go online because of coronavirus outbreak. Everybody knows that we are not able to conduct face-to-face conferences, but at the same time, it is our responsibility as a researcher. We need to keep our momentum. So mainly the research and the conferences, especially the Connecting Asia conferences, I can assure you, we do conferences because of three major reasons, and we attend, every researcher, they attend these conferences basically because of these three reasons. The first reason, the main reason, is basically research networking, and we want to meet many people, and we want to share our knowledge, share our ideas, share our research, and get the feedback from the different researchers. So that is the first thing every researcher want to do. Within the conference, and that's why they attend the conference, especially the Connecting Asia conference. The second is publication. We need to publish our work. Obviously, we have this KPIs. Everybody have to publish their work. So that is the second major concern why people they attend the conference. And then the third one is how they can receive the citation, the research visibility. So that is the three major components why we do research. So, or we attend the conference, especially Connecting Asia conferences. So that's why, although we are online, but what we did, we try to maintain these three aspects of your research. So first of all, we have decided to give you three options of presentation. Because of the research networking, we will allow you to present your research. The 5-slide, 5-minute competition would be now 5 minutes video challenge, and in this you can send us your 5-minute video, and we are going to play or upload on our Facebook and YouTube channel, and we'll try to share on different platforms. But at the same time, the researcher whose video is going to be uploaded, it is their responsibility to share their video and get maximum likes and maximum comments. So the more comments and the more likes you receive, the more opportunity of winning that competition you have. But remember, this is the one aspect of evaluation. We will do two aspects of evaluation. We will assign our own experts, maybe 4 or 5, to evaluate your presentations, and then in this case we will get your marks from them and we'll combine them and we'll try to settle it and announce the winner before 25th of April. So we will upload all these slides or all this presentation on 18th of April, and the competition will be going on up till 25th of April. After 25th of April, we'll try to assess and we'll try to give the announcement of the winner, and then we can have silver medal, gold medal and bronze medals for this. Similarly, we have poster presentations option. The poster presentation option, you can send us your poster, and the same we will share this on our Facebook and other medium. Then you need to get more likes and comments. So that is the two major component. And the third one is our online normal presentation that would be held on 18th of April. The all parallel session would be held on 18th of April. So we'll try to record and we'll try to share your presentation. Everybody can send us their presentation after the session, and then we'll try to share your presentations to the maximum audience. So by doing this, we can have our research network running on. So we can do this and we can have our networking session ongoing. On the same time, the publication side, we have already provided the list of journals on our website, so you can go with the publication options. But we are going to provide you two different options of publication. The first one is your extended abstract. You can extract an extended abstract of 1500 words maximum, and the link is available on the download portal of Connecting Asia website. So you can download an extended abstract, will be published as the conference proceeding. But remember, we are also publishing your full paper in Scopus Index, ISI Index and International Refereed Journal. So you make sure your extended abstract and full paper are a bit different, so there is no aspect of plagiarism. So we can allow you to send us a similar paper, so you can just rewrite or paraphrase your extended abstract in terms of conference proceeding. So that is the publication option. But the third one is the visibility, the most important part of our conferences, how we can get more citation and more recognition of our conferences and our especially for the participant, their work and their research article, how they can get more and more visibility so they can receive more citations. For this, we have done a lot of improvement since past 5 years. Now all our extended abstracts are already available on Publons. The APSS Asia proceeding is already available on Publons. You can also share through your PlumX. So we have already basically, we have already partnered with Clarivate Analytics and also elsewhere. So all these mediums are available for you to share your already published extended abstract, so you can get your research to be visible and you can receive more and more citation. At the same time, we will assign reviewers from the different countries for your work. So that will allow you to make your work more visible in different countries also. So this is how we develop this network, and we improved our visibility in the research published material. So this is the main three major reason why people they join conferences, and we'll try to maintain all these three reasons within this COVID period, where we are not able to do face-to-face conferencing, but still online conference we will not allow, or we will not compromise on these three aspects of the conferences. So everybody will enjoy all these three benefits of being Connecting Asia member. So we'll try to improve your research network, your more and more publication, and at the same time you can receive more and more citations. So that is how we can develop. And another thing, we have pre-conferences workshops. As in our all conferences, we have free pre-conferences workshop for all our conference participants. So similar for this time, we will have pre-conference workshops on 16th of April. The schedule will be announced maybe tomorrow or day after tomorrow about all these keynote speakers and our pre-conference workshops. So workshops would be available to you on YouTube Live or maybe Skype and other options. So we will provide you all the links maybe today or tomorrow. So this is the brief introduction of our fourth Asia International Multidisciplinary Conference. We are going to do it online live, but still we are going to provide you three different options of presentation: online presentation, 5-minute video, and the poster presentation. And at the same time, we allow you to publish your extended abstract for free, and also will allow you to publish your full paper in international refereed journal for free, and also we will allow you the opportunity to publish your paper in Scopus and ISI index journal. The list is available on our website. So these are the main answers of the question I received in the past few days. So that's why I feel it better to give you answer of all these questions. Now I'm okay to take any question. If anybody have any questions, you can just write your question on the Facebook, and then we can just reply your question. So I hope we already have few questions. Let us see how we can settle with these questions.
Sir, right now there is a technical issue with the internet. Our YouTube page is not live, so the people, those who are looking our Facebook YouTube channel, they can come here on our Facebook page. There are some questions from Usman Ashad. There are questions. Can you please do some practice sessions so that we can utilize the app before the event?
Okay, for the application, it is very simple. We have designed everything for even for the layman, we can just do it easily. There is no issue. At the same time, we will allow you to do some practice session before the conference, but on 18th of April. So you can be present here on 18th of April. So we'll send you email on this. So this is a good suggestion. We'll do this, and we'll try to give you a link for the practice session also.
Sir, there is a question in our inbox. Javed Tunu from the Pakistan, he asked the question is that, so what is the criteria? Do you think that the criteria for evaluation of the video, 5-minute, 5-slide evaluation is a proper, the winner will be the proper and the deserving one?
Okay, for the evaluation criteria, those who have already attended the Connecting Asia conferences, they are well aware of this fact. We never interfere in any evaluation process, but we try to strengthen the evaluation criteria all the time. So what we did this time, we divided evaluation into two parts. The first part is your recognition, means that the more you share your video, the more you share your presentation to the audience, and the more likes you receive is one criteria. At the same time, we will assign 5 experts from our side. They will evaluate you. And the evaluation is already available on your portal. So you can see your evaluation also. So it is already online. And in the past exercise, it's already available for those who have already attended these conferences. So there is no problem with the criteria, and we'll try to strengthen the criteria by allocating the people who have the similar expertise in your area, and then they can evaluate your work very easily and in a better way.
Sir, right now another question from Shamsu Abdullahi Sali Silawa. Sorry if any mistake in the name. Doctor, I need more explanation on extended abstract publication.
Okay, for extended abstract, remember your full paper would be published in Scopus, ISI or International Referee Journal. But in that paper, you cannot write that this is a conference paper, because we take it as a separate paper, full paper, full research article. But the flavor of the conference is in proceeding. So that's why since last 2 years, we extended our efforts and invite people to write for their extended abstract for the conference also. So it means that your paper can be considered for two publications. One would be considered as your extended abstract or conference proceeding. And at the same time, your full paper would be published in Scopus or ISI or International Referee Journal. So mean that in one conference you have opportunity for multiple publication. But there are some rules. Obviously, for this extended abstract, although it is a part of the same paper, but try to paraphrase it, and maybe you just change the name or the research title a bit, so it looks like a conference proceeding is different and your full paper is different. So that is the logic behind this conference proceeding. But I encourage everybody to upload your extended abstract, because now extended abstracts are available on Pablon and also available on Google Scholar. DOI number is there, and also we are already in process of with indexing with DOIJ. So indexings are there for your conference proceedings also. So I must encourage everybody to upload your extended abstract also. But remember, similar to your full paper, extended abstract will also be reviewed, and you cannot send us more than 1500 words, but less than 5% of plagiarism.
Sir, another question from Alson Lee Chiyun. Hi Doctor, for poster competition, only poster needed to be submitted. That is the first part, and the second part is when would be the presentation be held? It's about the poster presentation.
Okay, for the poster presentation and 5 slides, 5 minutes, there are no presentations. So presentations are for only normal online presentation. The 5 slides or 5 minute video and the poster presentation, they are being dealt differently. So how you need to deal it? You need to send us your poster. We will upload on our Facebook and our YouTube channel. Then you need to share it through your medium, and the author, they need to put their efforts to make it available to all audience and their friends and different researchers. The more likes and comments on your poster is one criteria for your evaluation. And the second criteria, we will assign few, not more than five judges. They will evaluate your poster in comparison with others. So that is two stage criteria for evaluation of your poster presentation. So there is no presentation or formal presentation required for poster presentation participants.
Sir, next question is the same towards the poster presentation. What is the process for AIMC 2020? This question from Rai Naveed Ashok, UTM.
What is the process for?
Process of poster presentation in this AIMC 2020.
I think I have already explained this one. You just need to upload or send us your poster, and we will share it on our Facebook and YouTube. So you need to share it through your medium and try to receive as much as likes and shares. So that would be the criteria. On the second criteria, we have different judges from our side. That would be second criteria.
Sir, another question is from ONG. He is our top fan, our Facebook page. So I have received the reviewer's comments about the patent certification for using the data from some other source. How can I present this certificate?
Okay, now we need to understand, being a researcher, we need to understand what type of issues we have during this publication process. The most important process is we use figures and tables from other research, maybe from some books and maybe from some other material. And we think it is technically ethical if we cite their name. Okay, there are two types of research. One is called open access and the other is called closed access. If open access and they have using a 4.0 licensing, DY or any other licensing, it is okay to reprint. But whenever you are using this for your own paper, you need a permission from the source author of that picture or figure or table. Not just citing the source. Did you took permission from the author of the previous research paper to use his pictures, figures or tables in your research? That is a major concern for us, because we don't need to have, we cannot afford any copyright issues in our publication. So in that case, please try to provide a letter of or certificate of acceptance from original author. But what I would suggest not to include any pictures, figures from any other sources or table. If you want to do it, please prepare by yourself and change it from the original one. So maybe you can add or remove something to make it your own. So in that case, I would love if you send us the paper or the work which is originally yours.
Sir, next two questions are related to the plagiarism. And what is the required plagiarism allowed? And the second question is, how do we check the plagiarism level?
Okay, so the maximum plagiarism connecting Asia conferences are allowed, it is 15% only. We are not allowing anything more than 15%, and this 15% you cannot have more than 5% similarity from one source. So there are two criteria now for similarity index. The first thing is you cannot have more than 15% of similarity index, and at the same time you cannot have more than 5% from one or single paper or single source. That can be any internet or any other source, but you cannot take more than 5% from one source. That is the two-fold criteria for assessing your Turnitin report. So mainly we use Turnitin software. So if you can use this software, that would be good for us. But if you don't, you can request us to send you your Turnitin report so we can share that.
Sir, next question is, Muhammad Abdul Qadir Adam. Please sir, it is allowed to prepare a paper without following the education research requirements?
Okay, for the presentation, there is no issue. You can develop any type of papers. There is no problem. But remember, for publication, we need to follow the certain criteria for writing a paper. For presentation and extended abstract, you can use your own logic or your own template. But for full paper publication, you need to follow the template and procedure guided by provided in your portal.
Okay. Next question is from Pakistan, Muhammad Ishwar. First of all, thanks for the fruitful session. My question is about the publication process time. What will be the time?
Okay, the publication process is tricky. It is not very simple. So let me just explain it to you. Till now, we have already published more than 5,000 Scopus Index research articles since past 5 years. So that is a big number. So we are very proud of it. But remember, publication process will take some level. The first level, we will send you the reviews, the comments, the basic one. I hope everybody have already received the basic criteria or basic comments from the editors. These comments are basically regarding your formatting, your missing data, your proofreading, English language and the structure of your paper. Okay, later on, once you have already submitted these revisions, we will submit your paper to the journal. So in the second stage, maybe you will receive maybe some of the comments, or maybe minor or maybe major comments from the journal. And that you need to send us after revision. Maybe this revision can be only one side, or maybe it can take several rounds of revision. So be patient, your paper will be published, but we expect that you will do all the correction required by the editors and from our side. So this time we are trying to remove all these issues we face in the past, and we'll try to remove your major issues in your paper and before submitting to the publication to the journal. Now this is the part of the publication process. Okay, the timing. This time we are trying to publish your paper before July. That is our practice. We try to publish your paper as soon as possible, but some part of this is in our hand, some part is in your hand. As quick as you can send us the revision, we can forward it to the journal. But at the same time, the journal also takes some time. So the maximum time we will take to 6 months, but we'll try to finish it as soon as possible from our side.
So we have a very short time, but I have too many questions right now. First question is our viewer from the Vietnam. Is there a reward for the video presentation, and what criteria to evaluate? This is the same question.
Okay, the evaluation criteria we have already discussed, but the award, yes, we have 1000 ringgit cash prize for the 5 slide 5 minutes presentation, and also for the poster presentation. But now this year we have divided this into two different prizes. The first prize would be the people choice, and we'll give them 500 ringgit, and the second prize would be for the judges or the researcher choice. So that is also, there would be two winners this side this time, and the prize money would be equally divided into two. So two from video presentation and two from poster presentation. The competition would be like previous time. We will have the prizes, and also we will have certificate for, and the medals for gold medal, bronze and the silver medals for participants of this. And for the normal presentation, we have best presentation award, and this award would be given based on the session, but there is no prize money for the online presentation.
Sir, there is a question from Priya Krishna, two questions basically. She said, Doctor, I have two questions. One, can I submit extended abstract? And second, if the extended abstract is selected for scopus, when do we need to pay $300 for the publication?
Okay, for the extended abstract is different than the scopus index publication. Extended abstract is just a short form of your research article, complete research article. The template is available on our website on the download section. You can go there and download the template. It is only 1500 words only. So you cannot send us extended abstract and the full paper in one go. What you need to do is, extended abstract would be uploaded in the website of the respective proceeding. We have two proceedings for the people who have science related paper. They can submit their proceeding to science proceeding SPS. Okay, and the second one, with the social sciences background, you can upload your proceeding to APSS, Asia Proceeding of Social Sciences. So two proceedings, science proceeding series and Asia proceedings of social sciences, these are for your extended abstract. The full paper you can upload to the portal, and once you submit your full paper to the portal, we will immediately review, and hopefully you will get the acceptance or rejectance from scopus within 1 month, and then you need to pay for the publication.
Sir, next question is also related to fee process. I have received Pakistani participants are asking the question that how much they have to pay for publication as the invoice is in USD. Question is from Pakistan.
Okay, for USD or any other country, if they want to pay, they can just use the Google converter, currency converter, at the same date when they are paying. So we will consider that in that case there is no issue for payment from on other countries. And also you can use PayPal account, so you can ask or request for PayPal invoice to our info@connectingasia.org. you can get this invoice and you can pay through PayPal. It's easier for you to.
Sir, another question is related to for the reviewing. What is the duration of a paper sent to you for reviewing? What is the duration?
Okay, this time the review process is very quick. Almost every paper submitted to the system have already been reviewed, and you will receive the review result within 1 week. Once you submit your correction, then we will forward your paper to the Scopus Index Journals. So review process this time we have done very quickly. So within 1 week you can get the review results.
Okay, this is question from Doctor, thanks for the wonderful session. Are you using EasyChair and Idhas conference system?
Okay, for the conference system, if you log into our website, we have our own conference management system that is more sophisticated than any conference management system available in the market now. So you can log into our website and you can you will be directed to this portal. And we have all available information for the participants and payment procedure, publication, everything is available in that system. And even the conference day presentation, your certificate and the reviewer certificates would be available in the system. So you can use that. And we also have a mobile app from our Connecting Asia conference management system. So conference management system is used, this is our conference management, we call it Connecting Asia conference management system. So that is very much okay, and it is better than all available systems in the market for now. As far as my knowledge is concerned, maybe in future there may be other software available, but for now this software is well enough.
Sir, time is running very quickly and we have some questions. Question is from the Nigeria. Is it possible to submit paper for publication this week?
Okay, you can submit your papers before 15th of April. Before 15th of April, you can submit your abstract, and once your abstract is accepted, then you can submit your full paper for publication. But maybe not later than 20th of April. So full paper we cannot accept after 20th of April.
Sir, most awaited and very concerning question. This is from Pakistan, Sayyid Anand Gilani. Doctor Imran, thanks for your detailed update. I have one question: that can you give updates about HEC recognized journal publication which were presented in AIC 2018 and AIC 2017?
Okay, this is something we are dealing with. And since 2017, we deal with some Pakistani universities for publication of our research papers to our conferences. And unfortunately, we are not able to fulfill that promise up till date for some papers from Pakistani journals. There are two reasons, the major two reasons. These journals, they have MOUs with us, they agreed to publish our paper, but later on they change their mind and they are just playing the delay games. And we tried our level best, but still we were not able to fix that issue. And at the same time, some universities in KPK, and I don't want to take the name of those universities, although they damage us a lot, but still, being unethical is the best of, response to any situation. So what they did, they collected money on our behalf in Pakistan and they published their paper who were paying directly to them. And later on they refused to publish our conference paper because they have already published papers from our name. We are already in progress of taking legal actions against them, because they damage our name and they collected money on our behalf. But unfortunately, in this situation, many participants, many presenters, they were suffered. So what we did, we already settled many of these papers, and hopefully very few papers are left, and we have already alternative plan for them. So we'll send them email within this week and we'll try to clear this issue as soon as possible. And we have more concern for this more than the participants. I know this is our responsibility and they are suffering a lot. So what we'll do, we'll try to provide them alternative options and within 1 week. And if they are not willing to opt that alternative option, they can request for their fee refund. That is also, this option is also open for only those 2017 and 2018 articles. But we'll try to, at the same time, we are consulting our legal experts and friends, so let's see how we can settle the situation. But these 2017 and 2018 paper, they have damaged us a lot, and we will not allow our participant to suffer more on this, and we'll try to provide you different options on that.
Sir, a question from Abu Abbas. He is from Dallas, and he is paying his salam and asking again and again. We have another question from Bahrain. What is the last date to submit the extended abstract for the AIMC 2020?
Okay, for extended abstract, you can submit up till 25th of April. Please remember, extended abstract can be submitted up till 25th of April. Okay, so 25th of April, you can submit your extended abstract.
Sir, next question is from Najiba Azimi. I have a review paper. Can I submit my abstract? One thing, and do it is need to be presented?
Okay, yes, review paper you can submit. Review papers are good if they follow the exact methodology. That would be a good paper for publication, no problem with that. But presentation, we cannot skip the presentation, because the main concern for this conference is always to provide you networking opportunity and see your work should be evaluated by the other researcher as well. So if you want to publish through our conference, you need to present in any format. 5-minute video post a presentation or normal presentation. So presentations is a must for our conference.
Sir, next question is from Yasir Bhatt, and Dr. You and your team is working tremendously well. The reviewer has asked me to correct the data presentation in the tables. What does it mean?
Okay, so when you are using tables, obviously you need to follow some basic criteria. This is very simple thing to do while you are doing this. First thing, what I feel when you do or tables, you do some common mistakes. For example, you are not using decimals at the same number. Let's say if your paper you are using 2 decimals figures, please use throughout the paper in all tables 2 decimals. If you are using 3 decimals, you need to explain 3 decimals. And there is a common logic. People, they think if they presented a table, it is self-explanatory in your research. No, tables are not self-explanatory, or even the figures are not self-explanatory. If you presented any table in your research, you need to explain each column and each value available in that. Maybe in concise format, if the things are repeated, you can just explain 1 or 2, and then you can tell the reader that similarly other values can be interpreted. But you must need to interpret each value, each column, and please remember at the top of first row in the column, it should not be empty. All columns must be labeled. Your table must be cited in your text. You need to follow similar decimal, and you need to explain each and every figure available in the table, and also similar criteria goes for the figure.
So there are some funny and good questions also. One of your former student from Pakistan is questioning that my question is how to become an awesome researcher like Dr. Qureshi.
Okay, there is only one method of doing this, is hard work. So if you want to be like me, you need to spend your time like me. That is it.
So, sir, some question from my side. That so, how you are looking this online conference? We are going to in a new world online conferencing, and after the social distancing and this COVID-19. So, how are you looking the future and this situation?
Okay, I think this would be our last question now, because we have another meeting. So, I'm sorry for I cannot prolong this session. For this question, what we feel for the future, I personally feel we are entering into a new world, and this situation, there are 2 possibilities for this situation. Maybe we can come out of it immediately after this lockdown over, but this seems a very optimistic opinion. The pessimistic opinion say that maybe this situation is last longer, and then we need to prepare ourselves for the new civilization, new methods, and new opportunities. For me, I think it is the best time to start online conferencing and enhancing your research network through online community. Computer-aided techniques are very efficient in this era to be in the network, and also to maximize your time availability, because nowadays we are working from home. So we need to explore these options, and I think this would be the future if we see this situation will be longer. It will take longer, this is my opinion. But let's say if it is not, then we may be moving toward the face-to-face conferences immediately. But up till then, when we are not able to do face-to-face conferences, we need to use these platform up to the maximum, and we need to continue our research and development activity, because the solutions, they always come from the research. Many of the universities, if you see all over the world, universities are now providing the solutions to any problem the humanity is facing now. And this is the biggest problem now humanity is facing. All the universities are working together, and by doing this online conferences, we are bringing different minds together to think and partner themselves with other researchers in to find out a similar solution for the problem. So this is my message also. So please try to participate these type of activities. Try to present your work to the different researchers, because of your learning also is there, and also you can find your network of doing that particular research. Because nowadays what I can see is mostly research would be online now. You can present and you can do your networking session. So that is where we are allowing opportunity to our participants to create their own networking. But we will help you in all regards, and also we welcome you to present any form of research. And we are also the message I give in the past presentation also. We need to support this COVID research. If any research related to COVID, they are free to present, and we also offer 50% of their fee waiver for the publication. We are going to pay their fee. That is our social science contribution to this COVID problem, and we'll try to investigate more and more solution, not only in terms of finding out the cure, but also the social issues arise because of this situation. We need to find out the solutions, and the future is to do your more research and find out a solution for your humanities. Thank you very much.